Thank you very much, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here. It took me a while to get here because I went to the other campus, and it took me a while to get to where I am at the present time. I don't know how to basically start. I'm pleased to be here, and particularly for Veterans Day. Veterans Day is tomorrow, and that tomorrow is 11-11-11-11. That means it's the 11th month, the 11th day, the 11th hour, and the 11th year. It was so celebrated tomorrow because it will not happen again for another 100 years. And I don't know how many of you will be around at that time. Or you will be? Okay. All right. So I think that that's a real memorial, real memorable day for me. It's very important because it was one of the first things that my father told me about Armistice Day. And Armistice Day was celebrating the end of World War I, which ended in 1918. And the armistice was declared on the 11th month, on the 11th day at 11 o'clock in the morning. So 11-11 means a lot to me, but more importantly than that, the thing that impressed me about it was that it was to celebrate the fact that we would not have any more great wars. That did not really come about. I was in World War II, and what I was hoping was that World War II would then end all great wars. We've had wars since then, as you know. I'm still hoping that there will be a way that we can avoid conflicts or settle conflicts other than by really at war, where people are killed, people are maimed, people are destroyed in many, many different ways, in ways that we cannot even imagine. I don't know if I was damaged. I think I was. It was very fortunate to get through World War II. I was in the 100th Fighter Squadron in Italy, 1944-1945. I was a member of the Black Air Force during World War II, and as a result of that, I am now what is known as a documented original Tuskegee Airman. The acronym for that is DOTA, D-O-T-A, Documented Original Tuskegee Airmen. That's what we are calling ourselves now. But we had an excellent record during World War II. Nobody knew about it. When we came back, we found that we were not in the history books. No one paid any attention to the fact that we really did exist and did perform, and performed well during World War II. So what was formed out of that was the Tuskegee Airmen Incorporated organization. And what its purpose was to tell the world about the experiences of the Black Air Force during World War II. One of the things that, that did occur, and we do now have a national organization which is called Tuskegee Airmen Incorporated, and we have chapters throughout the country. And the one of the most important one is the one in Los Angeles, the Los Angeles chapter of Tuskegee Airmen Incorporated. And I was the president from 2007 through the beginning of this year. Now our president is Lowell Stewart Jr. We had the movie Tuskegee Airmen, which many of you, I think, have seen or tell the story. It is a thing that really put us on the map. We have a new movie coming up. It's not our movie, but George Lucas is coming out with the Red Tails. The Red Tails is a movie which takes on and tries to tell the story of the Tuskegee Airmen in a way that would be of interest to you, and hope of interest to people and kids that are younger than you and also older than you. We hope that it's going to be a big movie. We don't know. It will come out on the 20th of January, the premiere 20th of January of 2012. So watch for it, and let's see what it is that you can happen. We're interested in our legacy, and interested in, because as you can see, I'm not going to be around too much longer. I'm 91 years old. I will be. I'll be 92 on the 30th of December, 2011. So I'm looking forward to that. But we are interested in our legacy, and we're looking for new members to join our chapter and help support and strengthen that. One of the things that has happened is that we have our new president of our chapter, Lowell Stewart Jr., is the son of Lowell Stewart Sr. Lowell Stewart Sr. was a fighter pilot for the 100th Fighter Squadron in Italy during World War II. We were in the same squadron. I was the intelligence officer for him, would let him know or brief him on what to expect on the mission and what kind of flak, what kind of enemy aircraft, and that kind of thing that he would be facing, and then to debrief him when he returned from his mission to find out what it is that actually happened, and then prepare reports which would go up through higher headquarters. And those are the things that become the official record of what happened during World War II, and that is the kinds of things that you hear about and read about now.